and the night of prayer as well. But we have a very potent word of the Lord that I received this morning around 8:30 a.m. And so I'm just getting it up right now. I'm going to timestamp it for you on here. We'll do 8:30 a.m. And like I said, the presence of the Lord just hit me while I was working on something in 2 Kings, and this word came forth from that. So let's start with the word. Hello to everybody jumping on. We're getting into the word of the Lord now. This is going into November. So this is the word of the Lord, and we are on the heels of November right now. There is a lot here. It is very intense. It is an intense time right now. You can feel the pressure building, and so more is about to happen. So I have seen the intensity of these words build because of that. So let's get into the word of the Lord. All capital glory, honor, and praise be to the Lord of hosts, maker of heaven and earth. The earth is the Lord's, that's capital, and the fullness thereof. The earth cries out to its creator. Creation cries out to its creator. Majesty, kingdom, authority, God sits on high, now glorified, King of all kings. And to his kingdom, his is capital, there is no end. And the Spirit of the Lord says this day, call unto me, my children, call unto me in an hour of noise, confusion, deception, serpents and scorpions. Call unto me, that's capital, in this hour, your shepherd, and I will answer you and show you great and mighty things which you know not. For I, the Lord, am revealing, that's capital, in this hour. I am revealing what was laid hidden for decades, says the Lord. I am revealing what has been locked away in vaults, says the Lord. Vaults of the banking system, system is capitalized. Vaults of the court system. Vaults of agencies that have three letters in your nation that have attempted to bury deep, capital, what I, the Lord your God, shall now dig up. For it is time to deal with the invasive plants at the root, says the Lord. And suddenly tear up, that's capital, their invasion, says the Lord, including at the border of America, says the Lord. The root of the invasion shall now be dug up in a public excavation, for the very large root that has remained in the dark and caused such to grow is about to be revealed before your nation. For the territorial spirits are compelling those filled with darkness to cross over that they may position them in areas that are set to be turned over for truth. And they are being positioned purposefully in those areas to attempt a coup, a takeover, a hostile takeover, that's capital. You shall hear this term used in this hour. For hostile takeovers have occurred to the highest seats in your land, says the Lord. Thus says the Lord, that takeover shall suddenly become a takedown, says the Lord, as they deceptively and illegally took and brokered what was not theirs, says the Lord. And there are those sitting in the position of generals and heads of departments of defense. They have infiltrated, says the Lord. They have infiltrated. Hamas is in those departments, says the Lord, the offshoot of them, in order to circumvent Israel, to feed information, to attempt an ambush of Israel in Lebanon, says the Lord. O Israel, says the Lord, an ambush. Be vigilant right now, for a trap has been set, and those in defense in America and your own military have set such up. Do not fall for it in this hour, says the Lord, for it is a trap. That's all capitals. And says the Spirit of the Lord this day, they have set minefields across America, attempting to cause explosiveness. Minefields of violent individuals have been planted in areas. They are being paid generously in order at their word to uprise, says the Lord. The spirit of provocation and antagonism have gone forth in this time, in this hour, to provoke the weaker vessels, to bring darkness into areas I, the Lord, have ordered to be turned over, where my power will sweep, that's capital, through and overturn their positions, says the Lord. Michigan, the highest seat is set to be turned over, for there has been an act in spite of me, a mockery, says the Lord, that has been judged in my courts, that's capital, and written on a scroll, are orders for those seats to now fracture and cause a fall. That scroll has gone into Michigan, says the Lord. Thus says the Lord, Minnesota will begin to will begin to turn on its own, says the Lord. For that spirit of provocation has gone forth to resurrect the anger of George Floyd. The anger and defiance and the violence that went into the soil of that state. The enemy in this hour is attempting to stir a spiritual cauldron that was set there with the help of the governor and those in the dark arts. Pray, my children, that this is thwarted, that the plan is exposed and that cauldron is destroyed, for they attempt to stir it up around the time of the darkest day of October, going into the first few days of November. They attempt to stir it up. They attempt to stir it up in Detroit. They attempt to stir it up in Chicago, in Colorado. Denver, capital, says the Lord. Denver, that's capital, is heading for a shaking if the highest seats and the mayor do not turn from the darkness welcomed in, for it is a high place, says the Lord. Mile High Stadium, says the Lord. Mile High Stadium. Watch around that area, says the Lord, for an old territorial spirit in Denver will attempt to stir up chaos in the streets once again. And says the Spirit of the Lord this day, the pressure is coming to its peak in your nation, says the Lord. For darkness gathers, says the Lord. They are beginning to gather, to chant, to rant, to cut themselves for blood. They gather to speak their curses and spells and incantations, to summon in powers of darkness that are meant to run interference. They are attempting to summon a spirit of death upon candidates and their children, says the Lord. The focus is slightly shifting to their children, says the Lord. All capitals here, the whole paragraph. They must stay under my covering right now and watch their words, for they are determining disaster against them, attempting to circumvent my orders, and those around them who are in a spiritual position must recognize ahead. For I, the Lord your God, have sent scrolls into America, scrolls of judgment, scrolls of promotion, scrolls of mercy, for America has cried out for mercy, scrolls of grace, a double anointing of grace, goodness and mercy have been sent into your nation and into Canada, says the Lord. Those scrolls have been placed on the soil where the White House stands. Those scrolls have been placed near the Washington Monument, which will fracture again, says the Lord. Those scrolls have been placed in New York, says the Lord. Those scrolls have been placed in Texas, says the Lord, in Arizona, in Wyoming, in California, in Illinois, and in the heart of your nation, says the Lord. They are sealed scrolls, and in the coming days, says the Lord, at my order, capital, they shall be unsealed, for disaster has been determined against the candidacy of darkness, says the Lord. What they have spoken continually in the atmosphere and denying and mocking the name of my capital son, Jesus Christ, leading the younger generation to err and committing grave sins for what they have spoken and sowed and the smugness they so operate in. I, the Lord, have determined from my throne, they shall now reap a bumper crop of the brokenness, darkness, chains, and deception. They have led the people like cattle. They have led the younger like cattle, and their herding days are coming to an end, says the Lord. As they have abused their positions, they have taken advantage of the weak. They have lied, stealed, killed, and destroyed to keep a grip on a seat that I, the Lord, have determined they let go of. As a spirit before my throne went forth and enticed Ahab into a battle to determine his fall and break Israel free from such darkness and wickedness and break Jehoshaphat free of such a bondage, so the same has happened. And my spirits, angels, have stood before me, that's capital, and one has gone out to be a lying spirit in the mouth of the advisors of the donkeys, a lying spirit and Ahithophel, says the Lord. Corrupt counsel I have sent forth and put a lying spirit and bad counsel in the mouth of the advisors. For she thinks she is being led in the right direction. However, the poor counsel of her own shall now cause a disastrous public meltdown, says the Lord. It has been determined and shall now go forth, says the Lord. And says the Spirit of the Lord this day, O Russia, Russia, How you attempt to gather the fold, says the Lord. How you attempt to gather such corrupt, wicked leaders with your delicate dainties and your earthly intelligence. You attempt to gather like wolves in order to go out to hunt, says the Lord. All capitals. However, if you interfere in my business, in my covenant lands, then you shall be hunted, says the Lord. You shall, North Korean leadership in this time shall turn and falter and tumble, for they are out for blood. And I, the Lord, have ordered a day of disaster if the leader does not return and repent now for the blood of all the innocent you have slain, Kim. He's talking about Kim Jong-un. All the blood of the innocent you have slain, Kim, testifies against you in my courts, and the outcry has become great, so great that Russia shall be ensnared for even attempting to make a pact with you. For there shall be a rush in Russia, a push, unusual events that the government, this is all capital, shall tremble. And I am doing, says the Lord, I am doing it. Your secret meetings, your small summits shall be exposed, what you have met about, for you are meeting to find a way to subdue Israel. You meet to find a way to interfere in the changing of the guard in America. You meet to see how you can bankrupt Israel, America, how you can further infiltrate Venezuela, how you can destroy El Salvador, how you can move closer into the waters of America and intimidate with your submarines and missiles to strong arm America into submission. There is a judgment, says the Lord, I issued against communism. And on that scroll, there are decades, that's capital, of charges that have now come to their fullness, and it shall see a severe weakening of its foundation and sudden overturnings of some of these nations who meet. As I, the Lord, all capitals, shall throw them myself out of their seats. Marxism has a judgment upon it, says the Lord, and as they greedily meet in that area of the earth, poor counsel shall be put in the mouth of their advisors if they trifle too close and interfere in what I, the Lord, am doing. They shall receive the poor counsel of Absalom, and a Hushai shall be planted to carry out such. Those nations cannot protect Iran or the Prince of Persia from what I, the Lord, am set to do. For it has been written within the Ayatollah's courts, on the walls of those courts, all capitals. My judgments have been written on the walls of those courts. Mene, mene, tekel ufarsin. You have been judged and found wanting, and now your kingdom shall be divided. It shall. The outcry is great in Iran, says the Lord. It is great, and the people perish for lack of knowledge, and the innocent are butchered by a bloodthirsty ancient spirit that is being cornered and shall be restrained, and the covering ripped off of the leadership of Iran. Thus says the Lord, Bibi, Benjamin, keep your hands clean right now. Keep your walk clean. Choose righteousness in this hour, for you are being tempted, Benjamin. All capitals, do not fall for this temptation, for your seat will not be secure if you do. I have yoked you as an ox to excavate and tear up decades of violence, decades of hatred, decades of resistance, decades of blaspheming my name, and it leaked into Lebanon, it leaked into Syria, and that leak shall now be stopped up, dried up, and closed. For the time has come for you to find the great root, that's capital, that hides in Lebanon, that is still hidden in Gaza, a great root greater than the mastermind of such an attack. And it is deep, and it will take my capital might and power filling you to tear this out. And when this happens, Israel will fear the Lord God Hashem, and many will surrender to Yeshua. For this is not the time of fullness of Ezekiel 38. However, capital, it is a precursor. So watch carefully, my capital children, who defects and speaks out against Hamas, against that wickedness, against proxies, for the enemy is looking to ensnare them and drag them back in. Son of Hamas who rejected such. He's talking about the sons of the Hamas leaders that rejected them and have been speaking out for years. This is who he's talking to right now. Son of Hamas, who rejected such, Do not, capital, allow the enemy to ensnare you in this hour, for that generational line must be severed in the spirit as well, for the enemy is attempting to push open a door and tug at your heart. And says the Spirit of the Lord this day, there shall be a changing of the guard around leaders, says the Lord. Around those running for office, says the Lord. I require deeper spiritual insight and counsel. I require it in this hour, and there shall be a shakeup and the truth of the wheeling, dealing, and manipulating that has gone on. The tickling of ears, the filling of candidates with nothing more than hot air is about to change. For I, the Lord God, shall make a way where there looks to be no way. Where positions seem to be set, I, the Lord, shall unset them, unseat them, change and rearrange to my standards, for I have allowed such for a time. However, this is too critical of an hour for superficial spirituality, sugarcoating, and dancing around the deep issues and circumventing the truth. I shall not allow in such a critical hour for this to go on. I, the Lord God, Elohim, Ruach Elohim, shall pour into my anointed a power, a might, a love, an accuracy in wisdom, an accuracy prophetically, an ability to see deeper to the source, the root, the nest of what is festering. I, the Lord God, am pouring a double portion in this hour for those I have called into areas of leadership and government in this nation. I shall now pour a double portion into them to endow and equip them, to fill them with now the extra they need to do such a task for my glory and run the race set before them to draw people to a relationship with me, the Lord your God, through my Son, Jesus Christ. No, capital, this day you serve a mighty God, a sovereign God, an everlasting God, a merciful God, a God that is righteous, and I love my children. Stay under my wings of refuge in this hour. Do not let the enemy's tantrums and rage shake you. For, capitals, I am your shepherd, and though this nation, the Trump family, those who serve me, walk through the valley of the shadow of death, they will fear no evil, for I, the Lord God, am with them. My rod of protection and staff of righteousness goes before them. That shadow shall not touch you. It shall not touch them. It may graze them, but it shall not harm them. For my light, capital, in that valley shall now subdue that shadow. Intercede, my children, pray, for it is the prayers of the righteous, the prayers of my children, that will resist, capital, and cause such a wicked plan to crumble and flee. I am God, there is no other. Go forth in faith and boldness, knowing I, the Lord, am ever present, and I am with you, even until the end of the age. Thus says the Lord, in Jesus' name, my Son, who sits at my capital right hand. And then he says, I, the Lord, am making corrections of what may have been overlooked. I, the Lord, am going back in time and making that correction, so that correction may heal the broken, soothe the cracks. As you honor me, the Lord your God, my children, those corrections will be made of where you were wronged, where that was taken, that was meant for you. Others tried to steal such. For their glory, capital. I am making that correction in this hour. And that is where he ends. And that last paragraph, which I'm going to read again, because it's so important for all of you to hear this right now. The Lord gave me that 3 hours after he gave me this first part of the word. Now, that doesn't normally happen. It has happened on some occasions. It happened to happen this occasion. And it says at the end again, I, the Lord, am making corrections of what may have been overlooked. I, the Lord, am going back in time and making that correction so that correction may heal the broken, soothe the cracks. As you honor me, the Lord your God, my children, those corrections will be made of where you were wronged, where what was taken that was meant for you, others tried to steal such for their glory, capital. I am making that correction in this hour. And that is where the Lord ends the word. Now, There's a couple parts I want to go back to in this word, because I know this word is long. But whenever the Lord doesn't normally use the word vaults, okay? Not with me anyway. Every now and then he talks to me about the word vaults, which normally means something that has been locked up very, very tight is about to be flung wide open. And he reveals a few different areas of this. Okay, Sadie, say hi to everybody, but you have to go now. Okay. So he said the vaults of the banking system, the vaults of the court system, the vaults of agencies that have three letters in your nation that have attempted to bury deep capital, what I, the Lord your God, shall now dig up. For it is time to deal with the invasive plants at the root, says the Lord. And suddenly tear up, capital, their invasion, says the Lord, including at the border of America, says the Lord. So he talks about three different vaults in three different areas. And then he goes into the root of an invasive plant. Now, if you've ever seen an invasive plant, once that plant takes root, very quickly what that invasive plant will do is go and try to take over an entire area to destroy the good fruit and destroy the good crop. So it grows very fast, and it literally suffocates, wraps itself around the good plant, wraps itself around the good crop. And because of that, it ends up invading that entire area and destroying anything good that can grow. So what the Lord is going after right now is these invasive plants in this nation that have also gone into the banking system, the court system, I believe, and the three-letter agencies and the border, and destroying them. Because once you tear an invasive plant up by the root and you destroy its connections, it can no longer grow unless you allow it to grow back. So that was something interesting to see as well. The word hostile takeover, he says you're going to hear that in this hour, that term used. He goes into as well what's happening at the border. Let's see here. Shall now be dug up in a public excavation, for the very large root that has remained in the dark and caused such to grow is about to be revealed before your nation. For the territorial spirits are compelling those filled with darkness to cross over, that they may possess. So the territorial spirits are luring those under the influence of the kingdom of darkness over from other territories to try to swallow America and expand their territory. In a way, that's what's being said here. Are compelling those filled with darkness to cross over, that they may position them in areas that are set to be turned over. So areas that are set to be turned over by truth, areas that are set to be purged, set to have a change in leadership. These are the areas right now that they're sending these individuals coming across the border, and they're being positioned purposefully in those areas to attempt a coup, a takeover, a hostile takeover. That's capital, the Lord says. And that's what he says, you shall hear that term in this hour. And he says, the takeover shall suddenly become a takedown. That's something interesting to note as well, says the Lord, as they deceptively and illegally took and brokered what was not theirs, says the Lord. And there are those sitting in the position of generals and heads of departments of defense. They have infiltrated, says the Lord. They have infiltrated. Hamas is in those departments. Now, that is one of the most explosive, probably, things said in this word. That in the departments that have to do with defense, the positions of general, like attorney general, perhaps, just for an example, things like that. The Lord says they have infiltrated, says the Lord. They have infiltrated. Hamas is in those departments, says the Lord. The offshoot of them. So the offshoot of Hamas is in those departments in order to circumvent Israel, to feed information, to attempt an ambush of Israel in Lebanon. So the goal is to try to ambush Israel in Lebanon. So some of these departments, it appears, allegedly, have been infiltrated by offshoots of Hamas in order to try to ambush Israel in Lebanon. And the Lord tells Israel to be vigilant right now, because an ambush, when the Lord repeats himself twice, he's really trying to emphasize that this is something that you really have to pay attention to and could potentially sometimes be imminent. An ambush, be vigilant right now, for a trap has been set, and those in defense in America and your own military, meaning Israel's military, have set up this trap together. They've worked together to set this trap. Do not fall for it in this hour, says the Lord, for it is a trap. So the Lord puts that all in capitals. He talks about the mind wheels across America of violent individuals that have been planted in areas that are paid generously in order at their word to uprise, says the Lord. And then he says the spirit of provocation and antagonism. Now, those are things that have not been said in words prior, but the spirit of provocation and antagonism have gone forth in this time, in this hour, to provoke the weaker vessels to bring darkness into areas I, the Lord, have ordered to be turned over, where my power will sweep capital through and overturn their positions, says the Lord. He talks about this in Michigan happening. He talks about this in Minnesota, one of the other explosive things that was said in this word. He says, thus says the Lord, Minnesota will begin to turn on its own, says the Lord, for that spirit of provocation has gone forth to resurrect the anger of George Floyd. The anger and the defiance and the violence that went into the soil of that state, the enemy in this hour is attempting to stir a spiritual cauldron that was set there with the help of the governor and those in the dark arts. Now, when you think of a cauldron, many times you think of witches, right? You think of spells, you think of the dark arts. Pray, my children, that this is thwarted. So when the Lord says these things many times, it's not only to expose it, but it's to activate the people of God to begin to intercede in that area, which then goes into the realm of the spirit, starts dismantling that plan, which then affects the natural. So pray that this is thwarted, that the plan is exposed and that cauldron is destroyed, for they attempt to stir it up around the time of the darkest day of October. He's talking about October 31st. First, I believe, going into the first few days of November. So he's giving a time frame here. They attempt to stir it up. They attempt to stir it up in Detroit. He talks about Chicago, and then he emphasizes Denver is headed for a shaking. If the highest seats and the mayor do not turn from the darkness welcomed in, for it is a high place, says the Lord. And then he says Mile High Stadium twice, which is where the Denver Broncos happen to play. And watch around that area, says the Lord, for an old territorial spirit in Denver will attempt to stir up chaos in the streets once again. Interestingly enough, too, he goes into the attempting to summon a spirit of death. So he says they're gathering to chant and to rant, to cut themselves for blood. They gather to speak their curses and spells and incantations, to summon in powers of darkness that are meant to run interference. That's number one. They are attempting to summon a spirit of death. That's number two. Upon candidates and their children, says the Lord. The focus is slightly shifting to their children, says the Lord. And the Lord said in capitals, they must stay under my covering right now and watch their words, for they are determining disaster against them, attempting to circumvent my orders. And those around them who are in a spiritual position must recognize it, says the Lord, they must. And that's when he goes into Trump Tower. Now, the my jurisdiction, that is a legal term, having to do with the court of God. Under my jurisdiction, says the Lord, for I am their shepherd. I am your shepherd. I lead you through the valleys so you can stand on the hills and proclaim my power, my goodness, my mercy, my might in this time. Now, why would the Lord warn about this and say this out loud publicly? Because there are times the Lord does not allow me to say this, these things publicly. But just like what I was talking about above, it activates the people of God to pray and intercede now against it, which then is a weapon in our hands, and it goes into the spirit. It begins to dismantle the plan in the spirit, which then affects the natural, and you see that plan dismantled in the natural. But let me tell you something. Trump Tower is a purse prize for them right now. It is most definitely a purse prize. And being that, and this is just coming to my spirit now as I'm talking, they're supposed to have a rally at Madison Square Garden October 27th. I would pray, because Trump Tower is in the same city as Madison Square Garden, New York City. So if the Lord is putting an emphasis on that right now, I would pray and intercede for that rally at Madison Square Garden, because I believe there is going to be a very stark sober standing for what, and who is campaigning for what, and who is jockeying for what, and to give them a very sobering dose of who truly is siding with the powers of darkness, who truly is being influenced by them, and who is not. And I believe a very stark dividing line surrounding that rally is going to be drawn, because Trump Tower is not too far from there. So just keep that in mind, because this rally coming up at Madison Square Garden, pray for the protection of not only the people on the inside, but the people that may be on the outside that may not be able to get into the rally. Pray for protection, because those territorial spirits in New York City, right, are going to, in this time, become very frantic, and they are going to lash out, and you're going to see certain incidences happen, and they're going to be, it's going to raise the alert, let's put it this way, in New York City. So just pray about that, pray into that. I had another friend that spoke to me about that today as well. Okay, let's see. And the new code, and says the Spirit of the Lord this day, there is a new code that has been written by the corrupt, a code like a serpent that is meant to get through the cracks, not the large holes, that is meant to bypass firewalls. Talking about judgment here. There are scrolls of judgment that have gone out. There are scrolls of promotion, scrolls of mercy for America, because America has cried out for mercy. Scrolls of grace, which 5785 is flanked by fives this year. Five meaning grace, a double grace, right? A double anointing of grace, a double king priest anointing with that. Goodness and mercy have been sent into your nation and into Canada. So now, the fact the Lord taxed Canada on to the end of this leads me to believe that scrolls of judgment action in the United States of America, you're going to see a very sudden and frantic panic coming from the leadership of Canada and an overturning of such. And it says those scrolls have been placed on the soil where the White House stands. So these scrolls of judgment and these other type of scrolls have been placed on the soil where the White House stands. Those scrolls have been placed near the Washington Monument, which is interesting because if you think about it, Washington is the one from New York City who made the covenant between God and America chose God. And they've been placed near the Washington Monument. And he said, which will fracture again, says the Lord. So he's warning what's coming to the Washington Monument as well, because even though it has to do with Washington, in some ways that monument stands in some defiance against Almighty God. He said the scrolls have been placed in New York as well, that these scrolls that were spoken about have been placed in New York, Texas, Arizona, Wyoming, California, Illinois, the heart of your nation. They are sealed scrolls. He makes the point to say that. And in the coming days, says the Lord, at my order, capital, they shall be unsealed, for disaster has been determined against the candidacy of darkness, says the Lord. What they have spoken continually in the atmosphere and denying and mocking the name of my capital son, Jesus Christ, leading the younger generation to err and committing grave sins for what they have spoken and sowed and the smugness they so operate in. I, the Lord, have determined from my throne they shall now reap a bumper crop of the brokenness, darkness, chains, and deception. They have led the people like cattle. They have led the younger like cattle, and their herding days are coming to an end, says the Lord. As they have abused their positions, they have taken advantage of the weak. They have lied, stealed, killed, and destroyed to keep a grip on a seat that I, the Lord, have determined they let go of. Now, what's interesting when he says disaster is determined against you, and I'll say this is one of the last things, that is a term that was used biblically against leaders that were corrupt, wicked, or trying to steal a kingdom that didn't belong to them, that God had judged. And he determined that disaster would come against them. I believe we see that in the case with Absalom. I believe there are other cases as well that has to do with this, with Ahab, when Micaiah stood against 400 bought and prayed for prophets of Baal and said that basically the Lord had sent a spirit to be a lying spirit in the mouth of his advisors, and the Lord has determined disaster against him. And that basically Ahab, after that, ended up dying in battle. The Lord goes into Russia and North Korea too. I would watch North Korea right now. Russia as well, because Russia's trying to reel them in. But the Lord has determined this leadership to falter and tumble, because the Lord says they are out for blood, and I, the Lord, have ordered a day of disaster if the leaders do not return and repent now for the blood of all the innocent you have slain, Kim, Kim Jong-un, testifies against you in my courts. And the outcry has become great, so great that Russia shall be ensnared for even attempting to make a pact with you. So the Lord is saying he's going to do something to Russia and judge Russia for even going near North Korea right now after the great testimony that has come against them before God's courts. People of North Korea, you cry out to Jesus Christ right now, and I am serious about that. You cry out to him in this hour because your nation's leaders will be dealt with in this time. And so it's just, I have to tell you, there's just so much in this word. It's, oh, in the, and I, the courts of the Ayatollah that the Lord said he's already written on their walls, many, many tekel ufarsin, you have been judged and found wanting and your kingdom shall be divided. The outcry is great in Iran, says the Lord, it is great, and the people perish for lack of knowledge. And the innocent are butchered by a bloodthirsty ancient spirit that is being cornered and shall be restrained and the covering ripped off of the leadership of Iran. And when they have no covering, they have no one to protect them anymore. So that is basically, it appears what that is pointing at. He warns Benjamin Netanyahu to keep his hands clean right now, to walk in righteousness because he's being tempted. He calls him out and he says, you are being tempted, Benjamin. Do not fall for the temptation or your seat will not be secured, that the Lord has yoked him like an ox to excavate and tear up decades of violence, decades of hatred, decades of resistance, decades of blaspheming my name. And it leaked into Lebanon, it leaked into Syria, and that leak shall now be stopped up and closed. So the Lord is warning him right there. He is warning him right there to not trifle in that area. And so there's other areas of this, but that's kind of the ones I wanted to focus on. There's one other thing I want to focus on in this word. The Lord says, I require deeper spiritual insight and counsel. I require it in this hour. And there shall be a shakeup in the truth of the wheeling, dealing, and manipulating that has gone on. The tickling of ears, the filling of candidates with nothing more than hot air is about to change. For I, the Lord God, shall make a way where there looks to be no way. Where positions seem to be set, I, the Lord, shall unset them, unseat them, change and rearrange to my standards. For I have allowed such for a time. However, this is too critical of an hour for superficial spirituality, sugarcoating, and dancing around the deep issues and circumventing the truth. I shall not allow it. I shall not allow in such a critical hour for this to go on. So we are going to definitely put this up on our blog. There is a lot to this word. There is a lot of moving parts to it. So it will go up on our blog, our ministry blog at arcofgrace.org. All glory be to God for it. I felt the weight of that word as I was reading it. These words are getting more intense as we get closer to just some very serious things happening.
Of 100 kilometers ahead of about 400 meters. It is a speed limit enforcement of 100 kilometers ahead of about 200 meters. It has been processed normally.